Hello guys! Now, it is now known that both Android and iPhone WhatsApp operating systems look and work completely differently. Now, what happens if you've swapped to an iPhone from your Android and you've left all your different types of chat history on your WhatsApp via your Android? All your WhatsApp messages, your images, and even your documents that are very important, and you really cannot afford to lose them. Does that really mean you have to start all over again and lose it all just because you've got a new iPhone? Is there really a way I can transfer my WhatsApp from my Android to my iPhone? Well, we have been doing some testing, trying to transfer your WhatsApp data from your Android to your new iPhone. Fortunately, after experimenting with some free ways how to transfer, we finally figured out a way how to implement the transfer. And in this video, we are going to show you our test process. So I really do hope these methods are going to help you knowing how to transfer your data. And also, if you like our content and want to know more about smartphone solutions, why not subscribe to us so you don't miss out on any of our videos that we upload, which may give you some tips or solutions. Okay, so now it's time to go dive in. So we will test the function provided by WhatsApp first. So as you can see, when we have some messages here, now we are going to have to use the export chat history function to transfer these messages. It is an option to export your chat history as an email attachment. This process is simple, and with a few minutes, you are able to transfer WhatsApp messages easily. You can export the chat to WhatsApp settings, select one chat history to export. Here, we are going to do the test. We chose without media, so this wouldn't increase the file size. You may choose Gmail or another email application to receive the chat. Here we choose to export to Gmail as it is a more secure and protect your personal information. Just type in your email address and tap send. Now we can open Gmail to have a check. You can see that the chat has been sent to our email. So let's take a look. This looks strange to me. Indeed, these chat histories were export, but it is separated from the WhatsApp. So this is far beyond the way we actually imagined. The transferred data that we've sent over to the new device will not appear the same way as it did on the older device. We wanted the data to remain the same on the new device via WhatsApp without actually having to open any other applications to actually view it. So we headed to the second test. WhatsApp also offers a way to back up our chat history via Google Drive. It provides many options for us to decide when we want to back up our data. In order to succeed in backing up to Google Drive, you may also need a Google account. Now we can tap Backup to Google Drive, simply wait a moment until the process is complete, then we can open up Google Drive on our Android phone to make sure the backup has been completed. The plan was to restore WhatsApp data from Google Drive on an iPhone. So now we can switch over to the iPhone, open the Google Drive, log in with the same Google account, and try to find the backup we just created. As you can see, it looks different from an Android phone. So there is no any relevant files in the backup. So we need to type in WhatsApp in the search bar, and what surprises us that it actually shows no results. So where did the backup go? It really is puzzling. Well, according to WhatsApp FAQs, and that's because WhatsApp doesn't really allow WhatsApp transfers to different platforms. And again, this method doesn't really seem to fit our expectations. In order to find a solution to be able to transfer between platforms, we looked for help from a third-party software called iCareFone for WhatsApp transfer. And surprisingly, it turns out it not only completed the transfer, but is also quite easy to use. And it really did go beyond our expectations. So we have put the link down in the video description, and here is how it works. First of all, launch iCareFone for WhatsApp transfer and go over to WhatsApp. From here, we can see two phone models. It is telling us that they're connected to both of our source phone and target phone to the computer. So we can connect the Android phone first, enable USB debugging in prompted, and once the Android phone is recognized, we can connect the target phone, which is our new iPhone, to the computer. Then tap trust this computer if prompted, then proceed to transfer. This will overwrite WhatsApp data in the iPhone, but however, we don't have any data in our new iPhone yet. So click continue. And then here we can select the existing WhatsApp backup or create a new one. So we just have to follow the guidance to back up the data. So let's go to the settings on WhatsApp again. This time we are backing up the data to local. Then the iCareFone can read the backup file to make the transfer. Once finished, click continue. And now it is getting WhatsApp data from the source phone. So here we need to verify the phone number for our data to be transferred smoothly. This is a crucial step. So please make sure you have disabled two-step verification for WhatsApp and connected to a stable network to receive the verification code. If you have not received the code sent by WhatsApp, you can also tap Call Me. Once the verification process is complete, WhatsApp will be signed out from the Android phone and we will be asked to sign into WhatsApp on the iPhone. Just some verification and settings, so we quickly skip the sign-in process. And once done, click on Logged In to proceed. The restore process will begin and the iPhone will restart itself and finish the whole process. The software will notify you that the transfer has been successful, so now let's check it out. It looks nice. Our contacts are listed there. Let's tap one to have a look. As you can see, that all the WhatsApp media and data, including chats, images, videos, and documents, have been moved to the new iPhone successfully. And that is exactly what we needed. So, some articles have also said that iTunes will also allow the transfer. So, we decided to do some tests as well to see if it worked. So, let's see how that goes. Firstly, we back up the WhatsApp data to the local disk so that the backup file could be found in the internal storage. Then we back up the iPhone to the computer via iTunes. The reason for this is that we can find the location on iTunes backup folder. Then copy and paste our WhatsApp data from our Android to the iTunes backup folder. Just regard the computer as a bridge, as we use iTunes to transfer WhatsApp data from its source file. Here we find the data file of WhatsApp on the Android phone. Copy and paste it to the iPhone's backup file. Then rename the database file because this is the format iPhone to recognize it according to the FAQ. Now we copy and backup the files from the Android phone and paste them to the iPhone. After that, we can use iTunes to restore the backup to our new iPhone. Hoping that it all worked. During this process, the iPhone will restart itself to restore and back up. Now, let's go and check WhatsApp. We log into our account, and here is the results. It doesn't look pleasing. There isn't any messages remaining in the WhatsApp. There is no difference between restart all over on a new iPhone. So this isn't a typical transfer that we needed. So we don't actually recommend you actually try this way. And we actually found issues with this on the WhatsApp website. So this causes that WhatsApp adopts an end-to-end encryption to protect your data, while iOS and Android don't exactly share the same protocols, which led to the test being a failure. So, well done. After several tests, we finally found a solution that actually worked. At this very moment, we can't find a free solution how to transfer between Android and iPhone. And some of the free versions don't exactly work because of compatibility issues. And for now, it looks like the best solution to transfer WhatsApp between Android and iPhone is through iCareFone for WhatsApp transfer. Though it is a paid software, it did solve the problem that the other three couldn't. So if you ever do consider having to transfer WhatsApp data, you might want to give this a try. So in the end of the day, thank you very much for watching. If this video did help you, do not forget to give us a big thumbs up. And we do appreciate if you would subscribe and share this video with your friends. And I'll catch you in the next video.